Hello students, I am Dr. Girish. Welcome all of you in this semester 4th. This is an outline of compulsory English which is prescribed by our parent university, that is Swami Ramananda Tirtha Marathwada University, Nanded. Though the titles are identical, but the content is different. We have already studied fiction, but this fiction is different from the fiction we have already studied in third semester. For the time being, in this video, we are going to deal with non-fiction. Do you know what do you mean by non-fiction? Non-fiction indicates a literature, a kind of literature which deals with the reality or which is factually based. Fiction itself is indicating imaginary things, but non-fiction is something that deals with the reality or the facts. Do you know who is this great personality of India's independence struggle? Yes, you have absolutely recognized this person, an youth icon of India's freedom struggle, that is no other than Sardar Bhagat Singh. Whenever we are referring to Sardar Bhagat Singh, he is always accompanied by his two comrades. One is Rajguru and other is Sukhdev. Do you know that Bhagat Singh was a voracious reader, a great reader of literature? Whenever he got the time, he used to read a lot of literature, and with his vast reading, he was a great motivator through his articles, which were written in different languages in those days. In this syllabus, we have an article to youth, which is written by Sardar Bhagat Singh just at the age of 18. Before we start the actual essay, let's recapitulate the life journey of Bhagat Singh, which is very essential to understand what he wants to communicate with the youth of India. Sardar Bhagat Singh, he is a great personality of India's independence, although he got a very short life, that is just of 24 years. Whenever we are referring to Bhagat Singh, he is popular as an youth icon of India, an idol for Indian youth, especially whenever we are referring to his patriotism. You have to keep into mind that he is popularly known as Shaheed-e-Azam. You have to keep in mind that this is a kind of a title which is bestowed by the people to this great personality. And obviously, whenever we are referring to Sardar Bhagat Singh, he is always referred as Shaheed Bhagat Singh. He was born in Lilipur Bang, which is a village in today's Lahore district, which is a part of Pakistan nowadays. He was born in 1907 and he was belonging to a farmer's family, but patriotism was always in his blood and in his family. His father Kishan Singh and his uncle Ajit Singh were active members of Gadar Party. You have to keep into mind this name, that is Gadar Party, which was a political movement popular in those days. He used to accompany his father in all these type of social and political activities. Bhagat Singh is remembered for his contribution in Indian freedom struggle, as he founded Naujawan Bharat Sabha, which is a kind of organization deals with the social affluent. He joined Hindustan Socialist Republic Association, which is briefed as HSRA, which was very active in those days. He was involved in bomb attacks in Lahore. He was arrested and imprisoned for several days for his involvement in bomb attacks. He wrote so many articles in Hindi, Urdu and Punjabi language to motivate youth to participate in freedom struggle. The present essay, that is to youth, was basically written in Hindi language and it was published in the periodical, that is known as Saptahik Matwala. So you have to keep in mind that to youth is an article or a prose which was written basically in Hindi language and it was published in Saptahik Matwala. Okay. In case of his contribution, whenever he is remembered for, basically he was a very peaceful and you can say a great follower of Gandhiji and his non-violence before he came across the two most, you can say, the brutal massacre by British rule, The first one was taken place in 1919, that is Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which is very, very of a brutal action done by General Dyer. In case of India's freedom history, we always referred to this as a black spot in Indian history. Second incident which deeply hurt Sardar Bhagat Singh, that was known as Nankana massacre. That was a kind of a Gurudwara which was also attacked by the British people, British rulers, and it took place in 1921. So look at that, there was just a gap of 2 years, and these two incidents deeply hurt Sardar Bhagat Singh, and Bhagat Singh became a part and member of violent activist revolutionary parties, and he was accompanied to Chandrasekhar Azad. The most important landmark action of Sardar Bhagat Singh was no other than he threw two bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly with his friend, that is Batukeshwar Datta. Batukeshwar Datta accompanied Sardar Bhagat Singh to throw these two bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly. The intention behind this bomb explosion was not to hurt anyone, but to protest against the British rule and their injustice done to the Indians. Sardar Bhagat Singh was arrested along with his two revolutionary friends, that is Rajguru and Sukhdev, and they were taken into prison in Lahore jail. But the popularity of Bhagat Singh was a kind of a boomerang for the British rule. Bhagat Singh never tried to get out of this jail, and all these three great personalities were hanged, and they were taken to death penalty on 23rd March 1931 in Lahore jail. These persons, especially Sardar Bhagat Singh, sacrificed his everything just at the age of 24 years only. This was a kind of an end to a great personality and his life journey. Now let's focus on the prose that is prescribed in our syllabus, and it is entitled as "To Youth," means this prose is addressed or intended to youth. According to Bhagat Singh, 16 to 25 is an age group which is referred as youth in this essay. I am going to tell you the crux of all this entire essay, but I appeal all of you to go through the original essay again and again to get motivated. What are the qualities which are mentioned by Sardar Bhagat Singh through his essay? The first one is amok. Amok in the sense that is uncontrollable. He compared youth with volcano. The way volcano cannot be controlled by anyone, it is full of power, or the way it flows from one place to another place, it is uncontrollable. The power of youth is compared with this kind of uncontrollable volcano. He made a second comparison of this uncontrolled power of youth with wild elephant. When the elephant becomes wild, it cannot be controlled at all. The second important quality mentioned in this essay is no other than the strength of the youth. Hurricane, that is a kind of a circular tempest, and we are experiencing the effects of hurricane nowadays. So Sardar Bhagat Singh is comparing the power of youth with hurricane. Again, he make a comparison between the strength and the valor of this great youth along with these waves of ocean. How powerful, how roaring these waves are. In the same way, the youth are full of power. The third quality, which is totally opposite the first previous two qualities, that is no other than the beautiful or delicate nature of youth. Sardar Bhagat Singh compared this beautiful aspect of youth with jasmine bud, and he considers that youth is nothing but the spring season in the entire life of human beings. So the student have to keep in mind these three basic qualities which are mentioned with a different comparison. The essay is full of comparisons, and so you have to keep in mind all these images in order to delineate or describe the power of youth. There are some mythological references in order to connect the youth with his ideas. Sardar Bhagat Singh used the different mythological references like Bhishma from Mahabharata. As you know that Bhishma is popularly known for his strong determination. Then the second one is Ravana. Ravana is remembered by Sardar Bhagat Singh for his valiant arrogance. Prahlad, Bhakta Prahlad, that is popularly known for his strong determination and his attitude towards Satyagraha. The last mythological reference is no other than Goddess Durga, who is a deity of power, giver of food and nourishment. But this goddess is shedding the tears. So it is the duty of the Indian youth to take care of their goddess and to revolt against the British rule in order to relieve their motherland from the clutches of this injustifiable British power. In this essay, Sardar Bhagat Singh refers to Patrick Henry. As I already told you that Bhagat Singh was a voracious reader of different literature, and so he referred Patrick Henry, who is a popular American youth leader. He motivated his youth to revolt against the injustice rule. There are two most important quotes that I would like to quote here. The first one is that according to Patrick Henry, life is dearer within the prison cell where it is the price paid for the freedom's fight. What he is trying to say that the life within the jail is obviously precious when it will be fight or when it will be used as a price paid for the freedom struggle. And Patrick Henry also appealed the American youth especially, and universally this message can be adopted even by the Indian youths according to Bhagat Singh. When a government becomes destructive of the natural right, that is the fundamental rights of a man, it is the man's duty to destroy that goal. So this is a kind of a message which is given through Patrick Henry by this great revolutionary Sardar Bhagat Singh. So he appeals the Indian youth to revolt against the British power. Now what are the appeals made by this writer and revolutionary person towards the Indian youth? The first one is to wake up from the sleep of ignorance and slumber, that is the laziness is there and a kind of a sleep of ignorance. So he appealed the youth to wake up from this kind of a sleep. Second one, to fight for your fundamental rights, especially the freedom. He insisted the Indian youth to fight for their freedom of India. The third one, to be ready for all types of sacrifice for your motherland. Yes, whenever he used this word sacrifice, he always refers to the youth, because he considers that youth is having enough potential to sacrifice for the sake of their nation. Next one is to work for upliftment of downtrodden. Along with freedom, it is youth's responsibility to work for the upliftment or the welfare of the downtrodden people. And the last one is to restore the honor of motherland. Once upon a time, India was a great treasure, and in order to restore the bygone honor of motherland India, he appeals all the Indian youth to participate in this freedom struggle to regain the prestige of our India. Sardar Bhagat Singh has given a slogan, that is Inqilab Jindabad, long live revolution, that is the meaning India, that is the meaning of the slogan. But he concluded this essay with a title or with a slogan, that is Vande Mataram. So he appealed all the Indian youth to announce their struggle and fight against the British rule by this kind of a slogan, that is Vande Mataram. Thank you all students. In this next video, I will give you the multiple choice question based on these prose. But I appeal all of you to go through the original text in order to get motivated.